know what it takes, and you're ready today to take them all on. You got the measure of your man, and you know that you can go all the way. Give it to him. Yeah, give him a taste.
Give it, give it.
Haven't heard that song in a while, Jason.
No.
Have not heard that song in a while. We've been on a break. Been on a holiday. You can probably tell I'm a bit browner.
Same actually.
Did the test. I got you this year. Sometimes you do beat me.
I do, but I actually got burnt the first day of camping, so I had to wear like long shirt. Well, not long shirt, but had to protect myself from the silent killer.
Go on a different shade. Go on a different shade of brown. All right, yeah. Welcome back. Welcome to the Kiwi NRL podcast. Tonight in the whare, we have our boy, Jason Weatherly. How are you, mate?
I'm good. Good. Good holiday. Still on holiday, actually.
Still on holiday. Tradies, eh?
Yeah, tradie life. How good.
When you go back next Monday.
Yeah.
One last week to live it up.
Yeah, worked out ideal, though, because I got a wedding on the Friday.
It's like a wedding.
A wedding. Nah, bed wedding. A wedding on the Friday, so kind of worked out good.
Sweet. All right. And it's me. I'll be your host, Lenny Brookie, as per normal.
Yes. How was your holiday?
There it is. It was good, thank you. It was very good, thank you. Still ongoing.
Over the kids?
All right. The kids are okay. I mean, I've only got two, but they're just over each other, I think. They're at each other a bit.
You can send them to those holiday programs.
Yeah, well, we didn't really have one around our area that I can see.
I'm sure there was one in Matamata.
Well, anyway. I wish to. If there is, please reach out. Might be too late. But yeah, you know, good Christmas, good New Year. Not much rugby league.
No.
Not much rugby league happening. So it was good to have a break, but it's good to be back on the mic, blowing the dust off the mic with my boy Jace.
Yes.
Exactly. But also, we have to. You always have to. You got to thank the people who pay your bills.
Keep the lights on. Three out of the four that I haven't fixed yet.
So shout out to Wins. No. Shout out to Fitzone. Fitzone Gym, based in Matamata, Te Aroha, Pairoa, and Waihee. You know, if you got them back from your summer break, you're feeling a bit, what's the word? A bit mutters.
Mutters.
Feeling a bit loose around, you know, in certain places where you don't want it to be loose. Then get on in. New Year's resolution.
You've rolled in after the New Year's break with a keg.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
You left Christmas Eve. You left the week before Christmas with a six-pack. You came back with a keg.
You left looking like a yardy glass. Came back looking like a keg.
Like a handle.
Hit one of the gyms up. Or go on their app.
Go on their app, man. Our app.
Your app.
FitzoneNZ.com. Go to the website. Check it out. We've also got a challenge. First challenge of the year coming up the first week of February. It's going to be a doozy. So if you're looking to get started now and jump on the challenge in February. Easy as that. Also, shout out to Tummy Hunter Consulting for all your immigration needs, mainly around mahi, around work.
We kind of clarified what they did and didn't do last year.
We're 100% clear. We're 100% clear what they do. But yeah, shout out to Tummy Hunter Consulting.
Is he still overseas?
Mr. Worldwide. Darley. I think he was in Perth.
Yeah, he's just getting that client base.
I mean, his kid has got more stamps on his passport than I do. That kid's been everywhere. But you know, shout out to Dre and his family there, sponsoring the potty. Tummy Hunter Consulting. Go check them out. All right. Now for the usual. Remember which one it is. All right, it's the plug they kind of have asked for.
So it turns out they're going to get it.
They are going to get it. I don't know about you, Jace, but I pretty much drank my way through all my Christmas break.
Yes. I did a bit of the same whilst camping. But then we also hit every scenario of weather you could in the
camping.
Wind, rain, combination of wind and rain.
Wind, rain,
sun,
snow.
So
any snow? No,
we didn't quite get snow, but
I did have a couple of days off in between. Just like I thought, I need to have a break from drinking, and I happened to have a few of these virtual realities by Good George just rolling around in the fridge.
How good!
So it helped me have a couple of nights off the piss during the holiday break, or off the off drinking.
Just but still get the feel for it.
You still get the taste. You get the feel. It's refreshing. And now you had a night off last night and tonight off the beers.
Yep.
And going camping again on Wednesday. So I'm just having three nights off, so I'm sticking to these. And these are just great for that. Like I said, great taste. You still got the...
It's still got the sound.
The sound.
How do they get the sound?
I don't know.
They get the same sound in every can.
Yeah. They must record it and then put it in each can.
On loop.
It's just a great way to, like, just ditch the booze for a little bit.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
You and anyone out there, if you've got a New Year's resolution to slow down on the drinking?
Because, well, Kiwi Summer is, you pretty much go hard on the drinking.
You pretty much, you go hard.
So it's a good way just to...
Take a few nights off.
Balance it out.
Yes, balance is what it's about, Jace.
Get yourself back to where you need to and then go again.
And like, you know, like I said earlier, New Year's resolution, you want to drink less? This is the tool, man. These are the tools you want.
Yes.
Great tool to have. Just have them in your fridge. If you feel like an actual beer, just try one of these first. And see, it might just wet the whistle and you might just not need that other beer.
Yes. And you can buy these from goodgeorge.kiwi.nz.
Awesome.
Or, I know they're in New World, Glenn.
They're in New World. They're all over the place. Anywhere you get Good George, basically.
Yeah.
And don't forget, if you're going on the website, use the code KiwiNRL10, get 10% off. And then you can also get other things on there, alcoholic beverages.
Did anyone get you the
martinis?
Beer?
No event calendar, no.
Oh.
Pretty shocking, actually. Pretty shocking. I'm pretty sure we put a lot of hints out there.
Yes. Like, if you're going to get me anything, make it the event calendar.
Pretty much, that's exactly what I said.
You couldn't make it any more plainer than that.
I got quite a large manuka tree. Like this, probably your height.
Oh, yep.
So it's quite mature. Tall. So I'm still happy with that. Get to plant that in my area.
Same build?
Yep. Same build, yes. Stick-like. but yeah, if you're trying to stay off the booze, get online at Good George Brewing. Use our code KiwiNRL10 and get 10% off. Why not slap a little bloody salted caramel espresso martini in there?
Yeah.
Just slide that in there. I had a few of those over the summer break. Magnifico. Anyway, I digress. We've gone on about it. But yes, Good George. Virtual reality. Non-alcoholic. Hazy. IPA.
How good?
Pretty good. Great. Good and great. All right, on to the next segment. All right, Jason, that's with the first question, mate.
Okay, first question. Uh-huh. Why are you calling Donny?
Tony, get out of it.
Call him back later. That's Living Carter, says, pipe dream guest if you could have anyone on and realistic guest goal. So someone we can get on and someone we'd love to get on.
Oh, love to. He's done a couple now, but I would, at the moment, James Fisher Harris is my man.
Yeah, I would love SJ.
SJ?
Yeah. Yep.
And I think those are both gettable.
Surely.
Realistic goal is, hey, I really like the, you were kind of left out of them for a little bit, but I did like the local legends kind of thing we done with a couple of the guys from Canterbury. So
yeah.
I guess goal I want to get is to get some more local legends on.
Yeah.
So if you know of any local legends around your local league clubs, they've just got a good yarn in them, then let us know, DM us, and we'll get hold of them. But yeah, I think they were great. It was some good.
They have some good stories, eh?
Yeah.
How good. Okay. Next. Hummercraft 12.
Supper.
I'm your widow.
Supper.
Dark horse team for 2024 to make the top eight. I'm going to go, see me see a dark horse team, the Dolphins.
Oh.
Made a couple of good signings. Hopefully
they should improve off last
and
year.
And all their players should be, most of their players should be fit again coming into it. Normally it takes a couple, like I think, did O'Sullivan? O'Sullivan do a ACL? Normally takes a couple of years, but they should be fit and firing, I reckon. Because they signed...
I agree, that's a good pick. A
couple from the Broncos, didn't they?
Yep, Farnworth and Fligler.
Mm.
Great signings. They'll be better for the last year. It's the second... Like, that was the only first
year. I reckon Dolphins.
All right, this is going to be... This is quite out the box.
I know who you're going to go.
It's pretty out there. So don't come at me. You can try to if you want to.
Tigers.
It's Panthers, I reckon.
Shit. Do you know what would be crazy if they just dropped fully out of the top eight?
That would be random. No, it's not them. I don't know if they're dark horse enough, but I'm going Sharks.
They're a bit up and down, eh?
I feel, talking to my good mate, Aaron, aka Young Terp, he's got a very good
eye for it.
I was just thinking, word around the traps is that Fenua Blake could still possibly be on the move. As of this year.
Not.
That's what the word is. Apparently hasn't shown up to a couple of trainings even. So if that rings true, he goes straight to the Sharks. They become quite the team, don't they?
Annoying.
Yeah. Leaves us with a big gaping hole. But one thing we're good at is filling gaping holes. So
that's what we're known for.
We can fill a hole. But actually, to be fair, if he did go...
Sally's all clear.
We'd probably need a swap back. So we could get maybe Royce Hunt or Emanuele and money our way, possibly. But we'd need someone else.
I reckon get the... he normally plays lock, I'm pretty sure, but... Shit, what's his name? The guy that made the most tackles in a game this year.
Fadukin?
No. Oh, I can't remember his name.
For the Sharkies?
Yeah.
Was it not Finucane? Hadouken Finucane. Anyway, it's the Sharks. It's the Sharks for me.
Sharkies?
I don't know if they're dark enough horse, but if that whole Fenua Blake thing happens, then, you know, I think that'll be great for their team. Not so great for the Warriors, but great for us.
Next question.
What are you trying to do? Trying to find them?
You were, it's going to annoy me now. I remember he was in my fantasy. Oh, no. I think he was in my fantasy team. Team list.
Just bear with us, Fano. He's going to find the person he was talking about.
Oh, no. Sorry. Cameron McInnes.
Oh, McInnes. The Mick. McInnes. Cameron McInnes, yeah.
He's a workhorse.
He is. He's very little. He's a 14, though.
Yes.
So I don't know if I'd swap him for
not for him. Okay,
next question.
This is maybe more you than me because I don't think I added anything to my body.
Your riding weight? Yeah.
How many kilos did the boys put on over Xmas? This is from Hummercraft 2.
I object, Your Honour. I think I put on about 3 kgs, I think.
Badger.
Which isn't too bad. What about you, mate? How much did you lose?
Kg, maybe.
You probably like, lost weight.
Yeah, I'm actually just... ready to go into the 2024 jockey apprenticeship. Just
you could. I think you could go on without trying. Hey, that ship's probably sailed, mate. But thanks for asking and making me tell everyone.
Hey, there was hums, man.
It's only 3 kgs. Easy dub.
next question. From brother_yin.
Kia ora.
Who should be the new Kiwis coach?
Yes, there's been quite some debate. Mm. What do you feel, bro? Do you think it should just go to like doesn't matter where they're from, they just...
I think this is going to be the easiest for us. Doesn't matter where they're from, they just coach the Kiwis.
And who do you think that is?
I like the idea of old mate doing it when he's finished with the Dolphins.
Waynox.
Yeah.
Uncle Wayno.
But we need someone this year. So maybe Stace could be interim again, and then it could be a Wayne Stace
Wayne could, well, the way, because we don't play in the year anymore.
Mm.
So they could look for a look towards Wayne.
True, that's right.
With a Nathan Kalis.
I'm going to say.
Stacey Jones combo.
Sailors Kalis,
Stacey Jones combo, the three of them. And then throughout the year, the Nathan and Stace can be in contact with the players and stuff, because I don't know if Wayne would do that as well. Ideally, it'd be good if we just had a Kiwi coach at that level, but we
at this stage we don't. So
not yet.
That's why I reckon just we got a go few, for who you can.
We got a few building. We're on the build, so
yes.
But I would say Wayno and Kalis get it.
Yep.
As well as Stacey Jones.
Yep, I like it. Next question. 15 underscore Harrison Ward underscore 155.
Oh, great. Kia ora, mate.
Ponga versus Manu. Who's a better fullback? Manu Vatavai fullback.
Nah. Manu Ma'u fullback. Joey Manu Ponga versus Ponga. I'd have to say.
I'm going Ponga.
I'd probably still have to say Ponga, yeah.
What he did for the Knights this year once he moved. And he was a straight into fullback.
Yeah.
Was insane. That left edge was crazy with him on it.
I think Joey plays excellently at fullback.
Yeah.
But I still think probably Ponga's probably a better overall player in that position.
Yeah.
I think Joey's definitely like he would be up there. He is up there as a fullback, but I rate him probably more as a centre. But yeah, it'd be hard. It's a hard one to pick, really. But yeah, I'd have to go with Ponga as well.
Next question. JJ Moike.
Kia ora, boy. Kia ora.
Friend of the show. Hope you're doing well, man. Predicted teams for the All-Stars weekend.
Oh. Shit. That's going to take a bit of...
Nah, well, I just had it here. I feel like it's going to be real similar to what we had going into it because you got trial games right around the same date.
Oh, yeah. So when is it? When is that game?
They're on the 16th of Feb, and trials start on the 15th. So gonna go probably similar to what we've seen with like the likes of Preston.
No mad changes.
Nah,
I don't think so either.
If it was a bit before, then yes. But with it being right on trials and people fighting for teams,
just trying to think who would be a bit of a.
Yeah, it's like
smoky.
Tua Peke might get a chance.
Oh yeah, that'd be good to see him in the Maldives team. That's a good shout. It's always hard to know because there's always a couple of like, oddball players. I'd say. Yeah.
Maybe.
Interesting.
I know because he's not playing this year, is he? Well, the old Leo Thompson's brother.
Oh yeah, he could be. Like I think this year it'll be Leo and Fish starting.
Mm. I just mean as an oddball one would his. Leo's brother get a chance to have a run, but I don't think he's playing.
No, he's still playing rugby this year. Then the Cheese, he'll probably need a run. He'll probably be good to have a run, so I think he'll play. Brenton Nicorda, Jordan Ricky, hopefully he's sweet. If he's not, Preston Ricky can play. And then Locke, get the taps.
Mm.
Six, you'd have... Depends if everyone plays, eh? But
because do we have Docker Clay around that area?
Nah. Oh, last year we had who played last year? 6 and 7. Oh, we had old mate Haz Perrin playing 6.
Oh, that's right.
Then who was the halfback? So I wonder if Hughes and one of Ponga will play. Don't know if you will. Hughes. Oh, he's 6. You got Cody Nikorima. Possibly he could play. Centres, you could have like Jesse Arthurs and Timoko. You still got Joey Manu as well.
I wonder if Walbrook get a run this.
Oh yeah, that'd be cool, eh?
Mm.
I think he'd have to get. He'll get one of the wing spots because who else is there? Rapana, Dell. But Dell had that off-season surgery, so he probably won't play. So I reckon Willie might get a go.
Mm.
That'd be mean. Well, Walbrook.
And then you got.
I always kind of forget wingers, eh, for some reason.
Is Greg Maju Moldy or is he?
No, he's someone. Yeah. Wingers. Oh, I could push Jesse out to a winger just because I could just cut him from the team for the other one. So you'll be Jesse.
I love Jesse.
Jesse Arthurs, Willie Warbrick, and hopefully Chance Nickel Clockstead.
Manu in the centres.
Yeah. Manu, Tim Moko, CNK at the back, Arthurs, Willie Warbrick, the other wing.
Shit.
And the Indigenous team, I'm not quite sure because I don't really follow enough.
Had Hines at thing last year.
Hines Schmeins.
Hot boy Hines.
Hot boy Hines Schmeins.
From next question from JJ as well. Best and worst signings.
I mean, it's still to play out, but I think Warriors getting Roger.
Yeah.
Especially with the team they already had. That's up there.
Yeah, best up there for me. Worst is them letting go Curran. I guess we didn't really have a hideout spot for him after all these signings, but I love Curran. I'm going to miss him.
I mean, yeah, sad to see him go, but once again, he's probably too good a player to be sitting, not playing.
Yeah.
Not getting that much game time. But yeah, I think every Warriors fan was disappointed, like, sad to see him go.
Dolphins signing. Herbie, great signing.
So that's a great, their two signings are great signings. Just trying to think who else.
Who are some of the Kiwis that signed?
Yeah, I'm trying to rack my brain.
Forgive us because it is our first show and it is technically still holiday.
We're still on holiday.
Holidays don't stop till February.
But I think, yeah, I think the Dolphins and the Warriors have signed well.
Mm.
Like the Dogs have signed good people as well. Somehow we're still like, I don't know how they're fitting them all in. Did Dragons pick up anyone this year? Anyone new? I think they did. Raiders, they've been pretty quiet.
Did they pick up? Oh no, because they kept Ben Hunt in the end, didn't they? They wouldn't let him go.
Yes, they are still holding him hostage, yep.
Gun to their head. You're not going anywhere.
Yeah, but yeah, those would probably be our top signings, yeah. Herbie Farnworth was a great signing.
Probably missing some, but...
Yeah.
Spencer Lenu at the... I think it's going to be an interesting one.
Roosters. Oh, yeah, that's a great signing. I think that's someone they needed.
Yeah.
That spark of that real, like... Dog. They had a lot of solid players, but no one who would come in and, like, blow the game apart.
You have... Jared come off and then him come on, they're both, like, dogs.
Yeah, and I think because obviously Jared is nearing the end of his tenure, so.
Yeah.
I mean, they had to sign a forward like that, and they've done well there. All right, next one, mate.
Next question. That Kiwi punter. Okay. Dream guest on the potty for the season, apart from me, of course.
Dream guest on the potty, apart from our man, Kanos. Hope you're doing well, bro. Gave us a great tip on Saturday, wasn't it? Carbonos, yeah, over in Geelong. We already said it, eh?
Yeah, pretty much already said it, so I'm going to do a racing one for when we do our Melbourne Cup one. Okay, it'd be great to have J-Mac on.
J-Mac would be absolutely up there. He'd be a great guest. I'm trying to think, you know, any sort of, like, racing, like any jockey in that's a mad league fan.
Mm.
I can't off the top of my head. It'll be him or it'll be hard to go past Opie. He's pretty good top there.
Oh. What's his name?
What about your brother? What about your cousin? Wouldn't get him on.
I guess he's not into the league, but his riding mate.
Bayless.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jake.
Jake Bayless. But anyway, if we're talking dream, it'd be J Mac, baby.
Yeah. Because we already answered it about the league people, so we might as well go horse racing.
But yeah, or Jason.
And he's back.
And he's back. He's back for the Karaka Million. Let's go.
Okay. Next question. Moldy _in_the_03.
Kia ora, bro.
_ something else. What you boys think about letting Curran go? Oh, here we go. Bad for the Warriors culture. And then he's got Capewell signing, which I'm assuming is like, talk about that as well.
Yeah, so we just said, it was sad to see Curran go, but I felt like he needed to go for his own career because he just wasn't getting the game time. Jackson Ford killed it last year.
Man, he was insane, and he didn't even get a starting spot at the Dragons.
Yeah, and Marata near Corday. And then you got Capewell coming, but you've kind of seen they're gonna sign someone because they let go of Bailey, Surinan, and him. two of our kind of backup second rowers. So sad to see him go, but I think it's better for him to go somewhere where he can get a solid starting spot because he deserves to have one.
But just limit how good you play against us, please.
Yeah, just play good against everyone else for us. And Capewell, I think, is interesting. It's good. He's a great player. A lot of experience.
Mm.
He's come immediately. So someone like that, he's probably going to start.
Yeah.
So who loses out?
Who are our?
Maratani Akorde, Jackson Ford.
I would leave Jax.
It's a hard one, man.
I feel like Jackson is a player that works up as the game goes. He keeps getting better and better as the game goes.
He's not an off-the-bench player. No.
Yeah. So,
and Capewell's probably pretty similar.
So then maybe Madata, but could you go Madata? I wonder if they're going to move Madata to a centre position and then have him as a backup.
Nah, because you've got RTS, Pompey and
Rocco.
Rocco Berry. So it'd have to be... Yeah, it's an interesting one, Capewell. Kind of blindsided me a little bit. I wasn't expecting us to sign like a kind of like a key second rower.
Maybe they've told him to put some weight on. And
unless one of them's going to play lock.
And free up some of Tohu.
Let's say if AFB does go, then they're thinking, oh, we don't need another prop. We're just going to play Tohu there, which I don't like. But they might do that. They might move Tohu to the front and have one of those other guys play 13.
And then you got Jazz on the bench normally. Yeah. Have to see what happens. Curran and Surinan were too weird, like, letting them go. Like, Surinan was such a mean, like, utility.
Yeah, he's a great utility to have. But then part of it probably isn't the Warriors just letting them go.
Yeah.
They probably wanted to have a...
more of a crack.
Yeah. I'm assuming. Because it's hard. They were in a hard position to be in, like always being the backup.
Yes.
You know?
Okay. Last question. The Warrior Holic. Is this our year?
Well, last year I said it wasn't. It damn near was. So I want to say yes. It's always your year. It's always our year.
Your year.
It's up to you. It's up to you to make it your year. So I'm saying yes, it is. Off the back of who we've signed.
Off the back of who we've signed and how we went last year.
Yeah, I'd say.
What do you want to see this year? You happy if we just make finals?
No.
You want us to be?
We're top four team. I don't want to see us slide back from being in the top four. We should be at semi-finals. We've got the team too.
Imagine if someone tipped them to be top four at the start of last year.
If
they put money on it?
They would have backed it, surely.
Yeah.
If you're going to put that call out there, surely you put money on it.
Hey.
You know, so where do you think they'll finish this year, Jace? Like, top four is a bit of a cop-out. So I'm going to say grand final.
I'm going to say...
natural improvement.
I'm going to say second up. Second on the minor premiership.
Okay, second on the table and they make the grand final.
Yep.
Against Penrith.
Broncos.
Oh, no Penrith. It's going to be Waz Broncos. Hey, it could happen. It could happen. I'd love to see it happen. But yeah, I feel like fourth at least, and if we're below that, I'll be disappointed. But I'm expecting to be pushing hard for the grand final.
Nothing below sixth.
Yeah.
Like, if you're below sixth, you're like...
if we go, then come in like seventh or eighth. Like, finish.
Especially felt like RTS signing, he's going to bring a lot of like energy to the team.
Obviously, there's a lot of things that could happen. So if it happens with injuries and shit, like, I wouldn't be that upset. But if we could keep our full roster, another year with Webster...
Sean Johnson doing Sean Johnson things.
Like, you know, if he can have the same year again, if slightly, like, even slightly better. All these guys, RTS can bring, you know, what he does to a team.
If he's not Rod Biver, Daly M, stuff like that. Well, also, actually, NRL.
It's just the way it works, mate. He wasn't robbed.
Yes. This year, just for all Kiwi fans out there and people living in New Zealand, just have it 1 or 2 hours earlier.
They're not. Have you seen the draw? There's a lot of 8 p.m. games.
No. The Daly M's.
Oh, yeah. Fuck me. I was away camping again.
I waited up to watch that because I thought Sean Johnson was a show-in.
Oh, and you waited to the end.
And it's like, oh, shit, KP's getting a few points at the end. Oh, shit. And then waited right to the end to see that.
I don't know. I didn't want to say so, but I did say he wouldn't have been getting many points near the end.
Yeah. But yeah, I don't mind the game time because it is what it is.
It is what it is.
And Lenny said he's going to commit to fantasy this year.
I am not. I'm going to commit to this podcast. I'm going to commit my time to this podcast instead of fantasy.
I like it.
That's why you're on the show, mate.
Yeah.
So you can keep everyone up to date. Yeah. Have you started already working away?
No, I actually didn't.
You haven't?
No, well, the app ain't open yet.
Oh, isn't it? Oh, but are you, like, kind of making moves already in your head?
Not really. Because then you... Nah. I'll just wait till the app's open, and then I can go, like, boom, boom, boom.
You're going to try and get RTS or what?
Probably not.
Is he cheap? Will he be cheap?
600 and something K.
Oh.
So I'm probably not going to go and start with.
Interesting, because he'd be centre. But, you know, it could be one of those things. Oh.
But then he's got wing fullback, so he'll get DPP.
Yes, he does play multiple positions.
So then
he'll
get centre wing. But yeah, we'll have to see. Hey,
it'll
I say
mean,
that now.
It'll be mean if you have him and then he's like you put him as your centre, but he plays starts playing fullback, points wise, right?
Yeah.
Will you have CNK as your fullback?
I don't know, because I don't want to go too many Warriors, because I want to go SJ.
Oh, okay. So what Warriors players are you putting in your S fantasy team? So SJ.
Probably what I did that started last year as well, SJ and Egan.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
At this stage.
Fair enough. Fair enough. All right, on to the next section.
Don't depends really what for it. Now watch me do my dance, I'm the player of the day. Day, day, player of the day. Day, day. Gee, woo. Just on that fantasy, yes. Depending how much he costs and what time and position he gets.
Mm-hmm.
Might do a young Phoenix Crossland.
Oh, yeah, Feeney. Fuck yeah, I've seen a photo of him bloody.
He's jacked.
Oh, man. Ripped up. Good interview of him on the Bloke in a Bar
podcast. Notice one arm was bigger than the other.
Yeah, not the old furniture. You reckon that's Photoshop or you reckon he's just got
Bit of time alone, man.
Yeah, great interview for of Phoenix Crossland on Bloke in a Bar.
Oh, his the whole episode?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was good. I actually did listen to it.
Then you get to hear of his, you know, his family's very Kiwi, very Kiwi family, so they would probably like to see him play for New Zealand. So
yeah,
open to playing for both still. So be a great little
stuff, Aussie mate.
JMK, Phoenix Crossland, the cheese. Ooh.
Imagine that.
Three little. That's a good little crew. Anyway, that's not what we're talking about. What we're doing.
Play of the day, but I think it's our top five.
Play of the day. Top five moments of 2023, Jason. We've got five each. And we'll start with you, and then me, then you, then me, then you, then me.
Yes.
All right. So basically, it's just your top Kiwi NRL Warriors.
Moments of the year, headlines of the year.
Headlines, moments, game.
Stuff like that.
Yep. All right. You can start.
What my number got? Five.
Yes.
I've gone back and watched it a few times throughout the year. It is, and I'll probably go watch it after this, because it gave me chills.
Horny, yep.
The signing of RTS.
Signing of RTS, man, so that was such a...
keep hitting.
The fanfare.
Yeah.
The media went nuts. I was just getting all these notifications.
Yeah.
Messages, group chats.
Shout out to Shooter. Message me.
Before it happened.
Yeah.
Oh, shout out to Shoots. Shooter McGavin. I mean, what a signing.
Great signing.
I was sick of him playing rugby, to be honest.
Yeah.
I was just over him not getting any real game time for the ABs, and the Blues weren't playing him. It's like...
Oh, to you see him back in that jersey. See him with the boys.
Oh, he's going to kill it, man. His little stint at rugby, and he'd be like, okay, done that, tried that, made the ABs, played like for 3 minutes, but it still count. Still got his cap. Now he can come right back to league and actually tear that shit up. Tear it up. Okay, my number five. It's probably a little bit of a cop-out, but the Wild season as a whole, doesn't it make a difference having home games?
Home games and a culture and a vibe that the boys buy in.
There's a vibe, there's culture, there's a coach, there's some players. It's the Wild season as a whole.
And just happy players. Like, the big one is Sean Johnson.
SJ.
You can see how happy he was.
What a story. What a comeback. What a... Well, he didn't really come back. He just... Come up. It's a come up.
Yeah.
It's a glow up, man. Sean Johnson played out of his skin like so many players did. The season as a whole, the whole country got behind them. This goes to show like once again with the home advantage. It's a thing, man.
Mount Smart's a place to be.
It's a thing. Like, we didn't have them for 2 years.
Yeah.
And then we went average. We all of a sudden got them back. Fucking semi-final, baby.
Here we go.
All right. Your number four, Jace.
My number four. Kind of similar to yours, what you just said, but the Wahs making the finals. It's all we wanted to see.
It was so weird, too, how we had a lock. We were, like, locked into, like, the top four.
I think...
Unbelievable.
I looked at it. We dropped out, but it wasn't for long. Out of the top eight once the whole year, I'm pretty sure it was. Something like that.
Unbelievable. I just did not see that coming.
Every Warriors fan listening, were you waiting for it to just drop off the cliff? What was that?
Sorry. Just rubbed my mic with my drink.
Waiting for it to drop off a cliff, and then...
But you can't blame us, all the Warriors fans in general, because, you know, we've become accustomed to it.
Yes, but holy so shit, boys.
Then there was a moment where we were like, we are locked in the top four. That was actual madness.
It was a crazy feeling.
That was actually crazy. Not because it was the Warriors, it's just because, you know, we'd gone through a lot, and then to do that after... crazy. Absolutely crazy. My number four... It's not one like, oh, it is. It's Dell, Dell.
Dell?
Delesniak. Dell and Martin is Delesniak owning the motherfucking right corner. He made that corner his bitch.
And the crazy thing is, he did that, and like, he almost got top try scorer in the like six less games.
Six less. And it's just seeing him score on that corner, man. Like, just Dell in the corner. That's what I've written down. Dell in the corner. That was my moment of 23. Like, if you just... Did they put that together? They did a montage of all his tries?
Did they
see that?
Oh, they did.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they did. And it's just like him in the corner, him in the corner. Odd intercept, hit him in the corner. Great season from the vet, Dell.
He did good. And then just a couple breakaway tries from him as well for the Moulé. Just
the Moulé blowing in the wind.
Getting some ear time.
Ear Dell, baby. What's your number four?
I already done my number four. That was Wales.
Oh, yeah, sorry, you were going first. Number three.
My number three. SJ, year in a hole. What a story. And I could put it down to four words that he spoke himself. Up the Wales, baby.
Oh, baby, I was like, you've stitched yourself up here.
No, because that's what he said in his interview.
Yes, but I did see last year, before the start, like this time last year, the Warriors posted a meme. Yes, because I got the memory.
Mm.
So that they actually done it before then. So it's been around a while, like just bubbling away up to us.
Yeah. He was incredible this year.
I mean,
or
Sean
last year
was just on something else. It was
he was loving life. He was home with his family.
Loving life, playing at a sold out Mount Smart, tearing it up.
And what was crazy, he had I remember that 1 week, re-signed with the Warriors, had a baby.
Yeah.
And like just in time to make the game and had a mean game all that 1 week.
He made the right call at the end of the year not to play for the Kiwis, but I would have loved to see him finish the year in the black jersey.
Yeah. That video of him and Madge. There he is. Because Madge is like, oh, we'll have a talk about you coming to the end of the year with the Kiwis. Classic.
Classic. Okay, my number three is just the Kiwis haka in general. The one against Samoa, wowee. Hectic. Then, the one against Aussie, we did lose, but...
Jeez.
When the bro, like, we all walked up.
Dana!
The old stare down. And then, that one in Hamilton. Oh, just the huckers, man.
Kiwi
League. It's just at another level.
Kiwi League guys know how to do the hucker.
Well, you know, it's predominantly... You know, anyway... It's not about race, but I'm just saying, like,
it's not about race.
But there's
a lot of less Sam Canes in the team.
Yeah, just a hucker from the Kiwis. Shit, it's impressive. It is bloody impressive, and man, it's just you get the goosebumps. And Fisher Harris is waving that big chunk of bloody pone army around. Oh, can't beat it. All right, what's your number two?
I'm going to change my one and two around just so we can talk about the other one at the same time.
Okay.
My number two. The Warriors win / comeback over the Sharks.
What a game.
Holy hecker.
Now, correct me if I'm right. So, were we kind of in it at all at the start?
No.
We just were. We just fully blew it.
We were like 12-0 down in like 10 minutes or under 10 minutes.
That's right. And what? How did we...
And then we grinded away. They were like 18-something.
Did we score before halftime?
We were 2 tries down at halftime from memory. And then the boys, or 2 or 3 tries down at halftime, the boys like...
We can
do this. We can do this. Because we kept them...
Might have been more, bro.
We kept them scoreless in the second half, I believe.
Might have been more than that, eh? What was the score in the end? Do you want to bring it up? If you can find it. Sorry, bear with us, team. Bear with us. But I would like to... I just remember it being the mad mountain of like, oh, shit. It's going to be hard to come back from.
23-3, and it was at the start of the year.
And it's just, you can feel it coming, eh?
I think it was around 6 or 5.
You can feel it coming. Must have been 5. There it is, 30-32. So they got 30 points in the first half.
Yeah, so... Oh, sorry, they got 1 try in the second half. So they got 4 tries. So they got 3 tries in the first 15 minutes.
Yes.
And we didn't get our first one to the 21st minute.
Yep.
And then they got a nut. So there were 4 tries up to 1.
And they're like, yes, come on, boys. And they got another one. I was like, bloody hell.
And then we got... So they got one in the 26th minute. We got one in the 29th minute.
Before half.
So it was 4-2, like tries-wise. Came back second half. We got one 5 minutes into the second half by Jansen. And then we got one 6 minutes later. So it was... 4-4, maybe.
Edward Corsi, then Josh Curran, but they got one.
But then...
Muli Talo put them back in front.
Then Josh Curran got a mean one from an awesome line from...
Of Shawnee.
Shawnee.
Pass of Shawnee.
And then the penalty kick to win it.
Yes, that's right. In the
79th minute, Johnson kicked it. We're like 40-odd metres out.
Man, that was... What a game.
And because we were just getting into the game, and then just before halftime, remember Marata Niokore
got sent off, and you're like, oh, no.
Yeah.
Never fold, though. Shit, they dug it in.
Oh, and because we started the year off so good.
Yeah.
And we're like, oh, shit.
We just let those tries in. It was 1 minute in, is it? Does it say that? First minute.
I was like...
It's like,
okay, please don't go back to what we've been doing.
In the 4th minute, then the 14th minute, and about 20 minutes is when we started, obviously, coming back a bit.
Yeah, and then we came back and won that game, I was like, okay, there's something different here.
We found a way.
The boys would have folded normally, but it was a story they wanted to tell their grandkids.
They did say that half time. This is a game you could tell your grandkids about.
And then go back and watch it. Sean Johnson with the best post-match interview.
At the Wise Baby. All right, my number two is the Kiwis cricket score against Samoa. 50 points to not a thing scored. Nil.
We were there too.
50-0. We were there. I was out there. I mean, it was just such a dominant display. And it's that hometown advantage, you know. Hometown advantage, what?
Oh, I just get flashbacks of you at the game.
What?
How you like that? How you like that? You can sing all the songs you want, but you still got to tackle.
It's true, though. It's very true.
The best part was...
Great game from the Black Caps. I was saying that a lot.
We were sitting so far down the stadium that Lennie would turn around and wave his Kiwi flag against all these Samoans and just be like, how's that?
That was just a pukana, not how's that. They weren't bowled out, even though it was a cricket score. You know, so it'll be that game. Absolutely dominant display. Shows a hometown advantage.
You almost got a fight in that game as well. Remember you went down to the bottom?
Yeah, one of the guys didn't like me waving my flag.
Don't you come down here again.
Oops. Just waving my flag, bro.
But yeah, how good was that?
So good. What's your number one?
Our number ones.
Our joint number one is...
The Kiwis dominating the Aussies in Kiri Kiri Roa. Is that it?
Yeah. Correct. Tika. Shot, bro.
Thank you.
Yes, Kiwis are absolutely humping the Kangaroos. 30-0, unheard of.
Nil. We kept the games that mattered.
Nil. So at home, 50-0, 30-0.
Yeah, that's what that was at both home games.
80 points to nil. We need more games back in New Zealand. It's as simple as that. As simple as that. And what a way to round out the year.
Samoa us get... Actually, hold the phone.
What?
You know what's shit?
What?
Australia's still number one.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that doesn't mean anything. That's what I said. Whatever helps you sleep at night, mate. There's no way they can be number one if they get pumped.
They pretty much just got dirty teabags in their face.
Oh, I could nearly change it to Griffin Neem's try, too. That was a beauty. But, yeah, absolutely humping them. Clinical. What an amazing performance. They just had no answers.
Yeah.
It's just scratching the tip of the iceberg for the potential we have.
They would try to do something, they'd force it and drop it. I'm like...
They just had no answers.
I was kind of speechless when I watched that game because I just didn't expect it.
Yeah, I thought we would win in a close margin. What I didn't think would happen is that we'd put 30 points on them and they'd score nothing.
Yeah.
Not one thing. Yeah, it was just...
And that's why international was better than Origin.
Well, yeah, Aussies won't think that these days. Now,
we should just keep doing Origin.
Should we just stop playing international? But yeah, it's just scratching the surface of the potential the Kiwis have and some of the players we have coming through. So what a moment. What a way to end the year out. Like, that was Christmas, New Year's, bloody Hanukkah all at once. Just that result.
That's why Lenny wasn't too worried he didn't get a... one of those beer advent calendars for Christmas, because Christmas came early.
I'd got all... Yeah, well, just like Jace, Christmas came early. You're welcome. You can use that if you want to at some point. That's great. But I think that's us, man. We've waffled on for 50 minutes.
Yeah.
Absolutely waffled. We're probably still kicking it. We're probably still going to have a week break for our next one.
Yep.
Just because, you know, just to wait for some of the news to build up. And then we'll be, what's that? We'll be well into it, under a month away from the Maldives versus Indigenous All-Stars game. So,
yes.
So there'll be plenty to talk about then. But very important, Jace. Now.
For our katus and fadu.
Katus and fadu.
Is it plural?
No, it isn't. Karu and Matu. Yeah, sorry. Not plural. You don't put an S on the end.
You can find us on YouTube.
Okay. For your taringa.
Spotify. Podbean. Apple Podcast.
Yes.
And then for all the socials, we got Facebook.
Instagram.
TikTok. And then you can follow and subscribe us on YouTube.
Follow, subscribe.
Probably just subscribe, I think. YouTubers.
You can follow now.
Can you?
No, I don't
know. send us mail if you want.
You can send us mail, 13 Short Street, Matamata.
Fit zone.
What else can you do? That's probably all the places you can find us.
Yes.
Don't forget, if you do want to cop some of these beers, use our code KiwiNRL10 online. Get 10% off. We've been the KiwiNRL podcast. I've been Lenny Brookie. This is Jason Weatherly.
And we're happy to be back.
Happy to be back. Go to the Kiwis. Give them a taste. Up the wars. All that stuff.
Yeah.
Peace. You know what it takes, and you're ready today to take them all on. You got the measure of your man, and you know that you can go all the way. Give it to him. Yeah, give him a taste. Give it.